pray for churches. When I say pray for churches, God said the men of God should all wake up. As men that are sleeping should wake up and begin to pray at this hour. This is the hour of prayer. This is the hour of calling upon God, looking up to the face of God, seeking the face of God and the face of God alone. Pastors and prophets and men of God all over the world begin to pray for the people of God in this nation. Begin to pray for churches. Begin to pray for the people of God. Because in the realm of the spirit, I see a lot of things. And God began to show me, he said, the men of God should wake up from their slumber. Men of God should wake up from their slumber. Men of God, pastors, preachers of the gospel, wherever you are, wake up from your slumber and pray. Wake up and pray, because this is the time that prayer is highly needed. God of vengeance, God of intervention, God of victory, God that giveth us power and God that delivereth, God, Jehovah God of Abraham, to rise at this time around and begin to pray. I don't know where they call Babalada. I'm seeing a place called Babalada. I'm seeing another place and other places and other places in Abuja. They need to pray. If it is possible, Abuja ministers should declare 7 days prayer. People in Abuja, declare 7 days prayers. The enemy is in the house. The enemy is lying at the bed. While the owner of the bed went outside to look at what is happening, the enemy has caught in form of a viper or a snake right on the bed, waiting for the owner of the house to lie down from a strike. I pray that God will give us victory in Jesus' name. Let the hand of God prevail. And let the presence of God take over. I begin to look at the spiritual realm and at the realm of the physical, and I pray that God will do one thing that will silence the enemy of our life. The enemy that has vowed that everything will consume. Whatever we need to do, if we need to all declare where we stand, let us all declare where we stand. If we stand for the truth, we should declare for the truth. If we stand for whatever we stand, we should declare. And so we have to do declaration. We have to all vote for what we want. We have to all sit and discuss the way forward. And let us all know where we all stand. If it is for truth, we stand for truth. If we don't want the truth, we declare we don't want the truth. But Bible says the truth may be bitter. But the truth is the sweetest thing that can ever happen to any man. You may look at the truth, you say the truth is bitter, but the truth is the sweetest thing. And this is why every man of God, every servant, religious leaders, or whoever you are, especially those that are clean hands, I'm not talking about those that their hands have been stained, or those that have compromised themselves. I'm talking about those with clean hands. Let them come out and speak and pray and seek the face of God, that we all may stand in the plan of God and the will of God for our lives and our destiny. This is the time that the destiny of everybody in this country is about to be decided. And that is why God began to open my eyes and I see what is called the month of this May, June, and the July. May, June, July. And then when I look at May, June, July, these 3 months, I see God also jumped from the May, June, July and moved straight away to the month of October. Month of October. Another month that I see in the realm of the spirit that I begin to have some questioning on what is already written spiritually and what is already there. Because prayer is highly needed. Because broken bottle. How do we now put up the broken bottle? The broken bottle has already broken into pieces. How do we now put it up? The putting up of broken bottle has to be by agreement and discussion. We know what to do with the broken bottle. May the Lord take control and give us victory. I believe in the hand of God, and I believe in what God and God alone can do. I believe in the ability of God, and I believe in the freedom of the Almighty. I believe that Jehovah never sleeps nor slumber. I believe that when God say yes, nobody can say no. I also believe that when God opened the door can never ever be closed. I believe that God is still on the throne forever and ever. And I know his presence is always with us. And I know his presence will not leave us in the name of Jesus. His presence will not depart from where we are. His presence will definitely work in our favor. For I know that all things that God is doing is the best. God has the best plan for us. Broken bottle need to be discussed on how to go about it. Whether to leave it, to now begin to choke people on the leg, or to sweep it and arrange it, or put it somewhere, or whatever it has to be done. Broken bottle need to be looked into spiritually and physically. Very, very important. Please, I want us to also pray that the presence of God and the security of the Almighty God will not leave schools, because I see schools shut down. Schools begin to ask, where is the school being shutting down? In the northern states, schools, Abuja, other states, I see schools shut down. The northern states, I begin to ask, these schools that they are closing, why are they closing it? And I begin to hear that the schools need to be closed for security reasons. I say, security what? Security reason. Because the enemy is in the house. Enemy is in the house. Enemy is in the house. Let the blood of Jesus and the God who made the heaven and earth intervene in this case. Let God intervene in this case. Men of God, pastors, believers, please go into prayers. Go and pray. Pray, because wherever there is God and wherever there is presence of God, there is liberty. The Bible says wherever the Spirit is, there is what? Liberty. The liberty is that when the Spirit is there, the people will now have freedom. People will have liberty. So we need to pray the Spirit of God should bring the liberty and the deliverance and the freedom of the people, because it is very, very important. And the people should now begin to go for competency. Competency, very, very important. Competency is very, very, very important. Without competency, we cannot head anywhere. The hands that are able to give us the competence we are looking for should be the hands that should be allowed to put a hand on the desk. And then I begin to look in the realm of the spirit. I begin to check out what I saw again. The Lord began to show me. I see where the politician now agreed and begin to discuss national confab. National confab. Everybody should come. But he's dragging. In the realm of the spirit, it is dragging. And they begin to say, oh, we are going to discuss, but look at how it's going to be. Let it be like this, let it be like that. And the Lord say, don't give condition. Don't give condition for national discussion. You don't give condition. Everybody will discuss and say all their mind. Then you'll be able to see the chaff and be able to see the original. When you get the chaff, you get the original, then you can know the way forward. But when you don't get the original, you only see chaff, 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 chaff. You cannot get to the root of the problem. The root of the problem can only be gotten to when the proper discussions, no restriction, no go area, every area should be touched. When every area is touched and every decisions are made and discussed, then you will see that the person that is heavy, when he has poured his heart out, or the person that is heavy has given birth, you will see that there's what will be a release. When there's a release, the will of God will prevail. We are praying for the will of God to prevail, because I see this very national conference. I see the federal government straight away went into calling meetings and they say, oh, let everybody come. We should come to Abuja. Then if care is not taken, I am seeing restrictions that will bring another mistake. Another mistake. Another mistake ringing in the realm of the spirit. You don't make mistake two times. You can only make mistake once. When you make mistake two times, it becomes your custom. They say, that is how we usually do it. That is what we normally do. But when you do something, you make mistake, you come again, you correct your mistake. And then you'll be surprised. The destiny that we have in this very place. Our destinies are shining destiny. We have bright futures. We have destiny that will rule the world. But let us not allow greed, which has already started eating up the destiny. Greed must not eat up the destiny we have. The soil is there. The water is there. The manpower is there. The resources is there. The giftings, they are all here. There is nothing you want to look for that is not here. Do you know that even the crude oil or whatever resources we use here, we may not need it. Nobody needs it. The intellectual capability and the wisdom that God has deposited, which makes God to always tell me, God will always tell me, say, my servant, I am giving all. I begin to ask, what is the all that God is talking about? God said, he gave all. He gave all. The spirituality, the strength, the wisdom, the human capacity, the human intelligence, and the human resources. Everything is here. You want to talk about the mineral resources or solid mineral or whatever, all those ones should be extra or jara to augment. The real thing are in us. And that real thing that are in us is what we all must fight to harness so that at the end of everything, we can be able to be proud of what we have actually produced for ourselves and our destiny. Please, prayer is needed. The school children must not be sent home for nothing's sake. God should prevail. God should prevail. Don't forget that in the realm of the spirit, I told you people what I saw, that I saw pressure. That pressure that I told you last 2019, that I said the pressure will go throughout 2020 and enter 2021. This pressure is not going to stop. What I saw in the realm of the spirit, the pressure I saw that is coming, the more pressure that I saw is not going to stop. Because in the realm of the spirit, God has opened my eyes and said, look at the pressure. If I can give the prophecy when there was no movement, nobody is worried, nobody is even talking, and I gave the prophecy and we saw it happening 2020 and 2021, then you should be able to listen to me. You should be able to hear the prophetic and the message coming from my mouth. So the pressure will not stop in what I saw in the realm of the spirit unless a quick, urgent action of strong dialogue and strong discussion is made. Because this is the pressure that I say, I see this pressure that made people from outside the country flying into Nigeria. And then I see everywhere, dear everybody, and come to your tent, O Israel. This is a pressure, spiritual and the physical. The pressure has gotten deep in the spirit. And when I look at the spiritual world, what is bringing the pressure? I am seeing blood crying, blood crying. Blood are crying. And I begin to look at those blood that is bringing the pressure. I say, what is the blood? I say, this is the blood of the innocent people. Innocent people. Innocent people. People that has not done any harm. People that has not committed any offense. People that their hands are clean. Their mouth are crying to God. Their blood begin to go in the realm of the spirit and begin to kindle fire the more. And this fire is what is burning in the country. And this is not something that can be quenched unless the right thing is done. This is a spiritual matter. I'm not here for politics. I'm here for spiritual issue. Because God has given me the grace to control and to stand in the realm of the spirit to, you know, communicate the spiritual aspect. So we all must understand that this is what is called spiritual issue. And then the spiritual issue must be taken serious. And when the spiritual issues are taken serious, then we can be able to talk about arriving at where we are going. Because you see, the heaven is higher than the earth. So the ways of God is higher than the ways of man. And so the wisdom of God higher than the wisdom of man. And so God sees everything and God knows everything. The pressure I see is about to be doubled, increased. Everything that has happened already that we are seeing happening, here and there, the enemy taking over everywhere here and there, is about to be doubled the more. And I see salary of people delayed from being paid. People's salary. Paying people's salary. People are waiting for their salary. And they say salary no day. Salary no day. No salary. No salary for workers. Workers pray. Workers must pray. Workers pray. Because I am seeing where workers was waiting for their salary and they had no salary. No salary. Prayer needed. Highly needed. Workers are waiting for their salary to be paid and they begin to hear no salary. No salary. May the Lord have mercy and the Lord take absolute control that the will of God and the will of God alone may manifest and prevail in the name of Jesus Christ. And I declare the presence of God will not leave his people. The Lord God Almighty, the Bible says God can never do anything except he made it known to his servant, the prophet. So we are praying that the God Almighty, who owns our lives and owns our destiny and owns our children and owns everybody, even in the nation and everybody, everything, he knows what is best. And let the best will of God be done for us in the name of Jesus Christ. For we can do nothing on our own. By our own power, we know nothing to do. We have nothing to contribute. We have nowhere to go. We have nobody to trust in. That's why the Bible says we should trust in the Lord. So our trust, our confidence, our hope is built on Christ. And on Christ, the solid ground and the solid rock, we stand. This is why a songwriter wrote a song and he said, on Christ the solid rock I stand, all other ground is sinking sand. On the ground is sinking sound. On Christ the solid rock I stand. All of the ground is sinking sound. All of the ground is sinking sound. The prayer and the agitation and everything. Everybody must be praying that we are standing on Christ, the solid rock. And when the enemy is coming with their proposals and their plans, God Almighty will defend his people. God Almighty will protect his people. God Almighty will make a way for us where there is no way. That is why the songwriter make that song very clear that his standing is not on the sandy soil. He's not standing on the roadside. He's not standing on anything rather than Christ, the solid rock. And so every child of God, our prayers and all that we are declaring is that we are standing on the solid rock. And God will not give us up to our enemies. God will not allow the enemies to overtake our lives. For our lives is hidden in Christ and preserved in Jesus forever and ever. So we will continue to overcome and will continue to be victorious in anything that we see ourselves do in Jesus' mighty name, I pray. So we must pray for Abuja. We must also pray for the workers in Nigeria. Pray for them because of their monthly salary being owed. And they begin to look at the money they are supposed to be collecting is no more in full. So God have mercy. God have mercy. And God deliver his people in Jesus' mighty name, we pray. We also want to know exactly what is the fear. What is actually the fear? The fear is that some people are thinking that, oh, if this discussion is made, if people come for discussion, oh, maybe when people discuss, oh, maybe the country breaks and this and that, my brother, my sister, it is important to be alive than to be dead. It is important to know your stand than to be a flying carpet. It is important to know where you are beginning and your boundary than to cross your boundary and then, in other words, being consumed. It is important to be alive than to be dead and buried in the shallow grave. So it is important for all of us to know that the way forward is for us to all discuss together. pastors should stand in the gap and pray for the will of God to be done. The will of God is the best. And when it is the best, we can go into competitions of being the best in the whole world. We can be the best in the whole world. We can actually, begin to be the best, that the world will begin to see us, and the world will know that of a truth, we are heading somewhere. We need to be the best. The best is what God has created us to be. Let us not go down from the standard that God has placed for us, in Jesus' name.